the smell of napalm in the morning.
Toyota, sponsors of the ITV movie premiere.
On the ITV Nightly News, Prince Charles's comments on the Falklands cause a storm in Argentina. Best news of tonight's football.
What are you going to do?
I just fell head over heels in love with him.
Talk to me.
I deeply regretted what I'd done.
Infidelity. It's Friday at 10.
Sandra Bullock stars in the ITV movie premiere, While You Were Sleeping, Saturday at 9:05.
I'm not engaged, I've never even spoken to the guy.
Manchester United have never won a two-legged European tie against Italian opponents.
A golden start for Manchester United! It's Dwight York!
The first part of a double header.
It's Dwight York again! From David Beckham's cross again!
Can they finish the job in Italy?
Quarter-final, that turned out to be.
Inter Milan, Manchester United, live and exclusive next Wednesday, 7:30, ITV.
Go on. Granny, is this your job?
No, your granddad and I don't work anymore.
Who takes care of you then?
Well, we've got our pension with Standard Life.
Are they any good?
Standard Life take good care of us. And they've been investing really well for years.
So they're old then?
Hmm. But they keep going from strength to strength.
Granny, is Granddad going from strength to strength?
I don't think so, dear.
Standard Life. For pensions, savings and investments.
Seductively well-built, the new SEAT Toledo. SEAT. Enjoy yourself.
Je m'en fous de mes amis. Je m'en fous de leurs envies.
Now you can rest easy. The unique Orange Value Promise means that should you ever think a competitor's tariff suits you better, we'll give it to you on our network. Orange, the network that performs.
Looking for number four.
British Gas?
Yeah.
Come to look at your boiler.
Yeah, he's packed up.
You can usually tell when you really need it when you go in the house and it is cold.
That heated, I've had it. I've got a damaged boiler, I had an accident on a building site. Without the heat, I'm in trouble. I'm in a lot of pain.
One of the terminals was loose on the top. I mean, I suppose I've been born into it, really, with father and grandfather doing it, I suppose.
So that nice blue van out there going to pull in, beautiful.
Pilot lights, first time now. I won't brag. Go outside, put a meter in the old flue out there.
Out there?
Yeah, check that's okay.
She's old. She loads up against the radiators.
Checks how well it's burning. 004, which is quite a good reading. Get my coat.
That's a lovely job done. See you again. Bye.
Bye.
John.
Summerfield's Price Check has great offers every week, like half price King Edward potatoes.
Oh, okay. Chips.
Yes!
At Currys, because our customers come in all shapes and sizes, we've put together a laundry range to match. In fact, it's now the biggest choice of washers and dryers anywhere in Britain. We deliver 7 days a week. And we promise, if you find a cheaper price locally within 7 days, we'll match it on the spot. Currys, the choice for you.
Currys!
Bring your mobile number to the network that performs. Call 0800 80 10 80.
Join us for Anglia News in 25 minutes. Tonight, how safe are the eastern counties? A new report on crime has the answer. and still smoking after the budget. Is a bigger price rise needed to make more people pack it in? Join us in just under half an hour.
Burning anger in Argentina over the Prince's Falklands comments. Elizabeth Dole declares tonight, could she become the first woman president? Prices crack down, the government investigates why Britons pay more. All the premiership action, how Leeds close the gap on the leaders.
From ITN, the ITV Nightly News with Dermot Murnaghan.
Good evening. There was a storm of protest in Argentina today about what the Prince of Wales said there about the Falklands. In a speech written by the Foreign Office but apparently delivered from the heart, the Prince appealed to the Argentinians to let the islanders live in peace. Argentina's Vice President called his remarks intolerable. Our Royal Correspondent Nicholas Owen is travelling with the Prince.
Prince Charles playing polo in a Buenos Aires suburb a few hours after his South American tour had turned into a diplomatic upset. It came thanks to an unexpected speech last night about the future of the Falklands.
My hope is that the people of modern democratic Argentina, with their passionate attachment to their national traditions, will in the future be able to live amicably alongside the people of another modern, if rather smaller, democracy lying a few hundred miles off your coast.
Argentina's suspicious. His words have stirred anger here, an intolerable attitude, Argentina's vice president is reported to have said. Even before the prince spoke, a violent anti-British protest in Buenos Aires itself. Police faced a hail of thunder flashes. Then came tear gas and a petrol bomb landed at our feet. The Union flag was set on fire. Street battles developed as riot police chased some 200 demonstrators. Trouble on the streets, maybe. The prince was busy with another Argentine speciality, the tango. His partner was one of the country's top tango experts. The dance ended with the sort of pose press photographers surely dream of. The prince is preparing this evening to leave Argentina after a visit which has suddenly become turbulent. He heads tomorrow for Uruguay. On Saturday, he begins 3 days in the Falklands. Nicholas Owen, ITN, Buenos Aires.
Elizabeth Dole confirmed this evening that she means to run for the American presidency when she set up a committee to raise money and explore her chances. Mrs. Dole is 62. She's a former government minister whose husband ran against Bill Clinton last time. James Mates reports.
She wants to be the first woman president of the United States. She will be the first woman ever to run with a serious chance of winning. Elizabeth Dole has not formally declared her candidacy, but today's announcement, made alongside a young girl who would also one day like to be president, is the first step on the road.
Know that officially, I have filed my papers with the FEC to have an Elizabeth Dole Exploratory Committee for the year 2000. So here it is.
She's already an old hand on the campaign trail, loyally backing her husband's bid for the White House in 1996, electrifying the Republican convention with a personal plea to support him.
And isn't that exactly what we want in the President of the United States?
But standing against her for the nomination will be an even more famous name in Republican politics, George Bush Jr., son of a president, the present governor of Texas. He's already built up huge momentum and is the hot favorite to be his party's candidate.
For many Republicans, the dream ticket would be to have Elizabeth Dole as George Bush Jr.'s vice presidential running mate. But the first primary is still almost a year away. Much can change yet. James Mates, ITN, Washington.
Here, the Prime Minister and the Conservative leader, William Hague, clashed repeatedly in the Commons today over whether yesterday's budget really did cut taxes. Mr. Hague said taxes were going up under Labour, but Mr. Blair insisted they were coming down. Here's some of what they had to say.
So now let's cut the waffle and the propaganda. And let's have the answer to the question that I asked. This is Prime Minister's question time. What is the total tax increase for the coming year as a result of the government's budgets to date?
There isn't a tax increase. No, I'm afraid, Madam Speaker, I have to tell him. There isn't a tax increase. The tax is falling by £4.5 billion net. The average family is £740 a year better off.
Well, over now to our political correspondent, Lauren Taylor. So, Lauren, who's right?
Well, the thing is, they're both right, but they were arguing about two different periods. William Hague wanted to talk about tax rises since Labour has come to power, but of course Tony Blair wanted to argue about the effect that this budget will have, and he says that will mean tax cuts. And the whole battleground here is perceptions in a year of regional and European elections. Labour wants to portray itself as the party that's cutting taxes, and of course the Tories want to portray Labour as the party that's raising them.
And Lauren, is that the end of the argument?
Well, the debate is finished for this evening, but it does go on for another 2 days. And the Home, Education and Health Secretaries all have to come along and spell out the detail of what their money is going to be, the money that's been given them in the budget. But I think the issue of tax is going to continue to be a problem. The Liberal Democrats, for instance, are already arguing that instead of cutting the basic rate of tax to 22 pence, the government should instead have been focusing on putting more money into education from that money.
Lauren, thanks a lot. A fair prices crusade was announced by the Trade Secretary, Stephen Byers, today. International comparisons are being made to see if and why we pay more for consumer goods here than they do in Europe and America. Chris Choi reports.
Some see shopping overseas as the only escape from rip-off prices. Now government has acted.
I have begun today a study on international price comparisons. It will be made public so that consumers and others can comment.
There are huge price gaps. A Renault Megane would cost you £1,300 less in Europe. On a camcorder, you can save up to £150. An average CD is £2 cheaper. And a large box of soap powder bought abroad will save you around £1.50.
Consumers in this country are being ripped off in a number of markets, from cars, children's clothes, CDs. And therefore, this announcement from the minister is very welcome if he delivers.
Electricity charges will also be checked. Money-grabbing firms will be targeted by fair trade officials with toughened powers. Tonight, business groups counterattacked, saying taxes and standards are higher in Britain.
Today, the government strongly signalled it wants to be seen as a consumer champion. That could lead to cheaper prices. It will almost certainly mean clashes with some of Labour's new friends in business. Chris Choi, ITN, Central London.
And we heard more today about the government's intended crackdown on tobacco smuggling. The Chancellor blamed organised crime and promised any resources needed to fight it. Tobacco smuggling has risen as the level of duty here has gone up. It's estimated that 10% of all cigarettes sold in Britain are now contraband. It costs the Treasury £1.5 billion a year in lost revenues. A high-profile figure with clout will be appointed to lead the government's campaign. The floods in the Derwent Valley in Yorkshire began to go down today. It's still expected to be the weekend at the earliest before people flooded out can go home and they can see about getting trains running again. ITN's Colin Baker is there tonight and has the latest.
It's going away slowly, but it's not over yet. The Derwent is still on red alert tonight. The rail link may open at the weekend if there's no more rain, but for those householders forced to evacuate, they've still to return and count the cost. The Environment Agency says it hopes the waters will noticeably subside by the weekend, but there may be problems in villages downstream as the flood recedes. The Floods Minister, Elliot Morley, came to view today.
Are you all right up there?
Fine.
Good. Being looked after?
He said he was satisfied with the alert system that warned of the flood.
I do believe that the warning system did work. There may be the odd person who was missed out, and of course that's something we'll have to look at.
So are you blaming the people for not taking notice rather than giving them an adequate warning?
I'm not blaming anybody, but what I'm saying to you is that I believe that the warning system worked and the warnings were given in time for people to take action.
There's no doubt that here in Malton in the last 24 hours, the levels have dropped by at least a foot. The new problem is that more heavy rain is forecast. It won't add to the flood water that's already here. It just means it'll take longer to disappear. Colin Baker, ITN, North Yorkshire.
The education watchdog Ofsted today accused many schools in England of unwitting institutional racism, the charge recently laid against the Metropolitan Police. An Ofsted report said Pakistani, Bangladeshi and Black Caribbean children, especially boys, were underachieving and said schools had to tackle prejudice and stereotyping. The American envoy Richard Holbrooke has been in crisis talks with President Slobodan Milosevic tonight about Kosovo. The Serb leader apparently insisted he wouldn't allow foreign troops in, a key part of the peace plan. Today there was no let-up in the fighting in Kosovo, as ITN's Bill Neely saw.
Serbian troops bombarding villages in Kosovo. We witnessed a day-long attack on a string of villages. Tanks pounding houses, soldiers firing on suspected rebels inside. These are the men they're targeting, the rebels fighting for an independent Kosovo. But they too are breaking the ceasefire. Last year's agreement is dead.
These rebels are several hundred yards from the Serb front line, and there's been intense shooting here for the past 2 days. But their leaders have now apparently agreed to sign a peace deal with the Serbs, a deal that doesn't give them what they're fighting for, which is independence.
We are just days from an even greater tragedy, says Richard Holbrook, the man who is now pressuring the Serbs to sign up to a peace that, as we witnessed, clearly does not exist in Kosovo today. Bill Neely, ITN, Vucitern.
Football now, and it was Chelsea against Manchester United tonight in their FA Cup quarter-final replay. The winners meet Arsenal in the semi-finals. Highlights are here on ITV at 11:40, so if you don't want to know the result, look away now. And there were four games tonight in the English Premiership. The results: Blackburn 1, Everton 2, Derby 2, Aston Villa 1, Leeds United 2, Tottenham 0, and Nottingham Forest 1, Newcastle 2. Here's Peter Staunton.
A bad-tempered affair at Elland Road, where Leeds were trying to beat Tottenham for the first time this season. David O'Leary's men calmed down enough to take the lead right on half-time. Alan Smith perfectly placed for the rebound. A second-half strike from Harry Kewell gave Leeds the points. They strengthened their claim for a place in Europe. Tottenham are going nowhere, in the league at least. Derby did their European ambitions a power of good, Dion Burton scoring their second against Villa, who once again looked a shadow of the team which led the way early in the season. Villa's Thompson pulled a goal back, but it wasn't enough. More goals for Everton, who won tonight with two from Bakayoko. It leaves Blackburn in serious trouble. And Newcastle's Haman scored the goal of the night, which gave his side the points against Forest. Peter Staunton, ITN Sport.
The numbers in tonight's national lottery draw were 8, 18, 27, 32, 36 and 49. The bonus ball was 46. Camelot say four ticket holders will share the £4 million jackpot. Tonight's headlines again. There was a storm of protest in Argentina after the Prince of Wales appealed to Argentinians to let the Falkland Islanders live in peace. And the Prime Minister and the Conservative leader, William Hague, clashed in the House of Commons over whether yesterday's budget really did cut taxes. Now, a look at tomorrow's papers. The Telegraph leads on that Argentinian fury over Prince Charles's comments on the Falklands. The Independent says a British diplomat in Congo has been branded a spy and expelled. The Express says Europe is threatening to ban the sale of traditional herbal cures in the high street. And the Mirror's front page is also dominated by the Prince Charles Argentinian visit, focusing on that dance. Finally, the build-up to the biggest fight of the year started in America tonight. It's between Lennox Lewis, bidding to be the first Briton in more than a century to hold the undisputed world heavyweight title, and Evander Holyfield. Graham Miller heard what they're saying.
24 hours before the weigh-in, and Lennox Lewis is in New York, putting the finishing touches to his preparations for Saturday's big fight. With the clock ticking down, the routine now, Lewis says, is to concentrate on the contest and ignore everything else.
The most I need to do right now is do my talking in the ring. And that's on Saturday night, where I will walk into the ring with one belt and come out with three.
Evander Holyfield in the white gloves is the more experienced of the two. He's been in with the best, boasting two victories over Mike Tyson. He's not a boxer who normally predicts the outcome, but he insists Lennox will fall in three.
I'm just going to tell you the truth. I was going to do it quietly, but I said, well, tell the people that you're just going to do what you're going to do. So I just told the people, yeah, I'm going to knock him out in the third round.
Lennox told me in his training camp that he believes Holyfield is worried about fighting a taller and heavier opponent. He'll earn $10 million on Saturday, but if he becomes the undisputed heavyweight champion, he's set to wear the crown of the richest British sportsman of all time. Graham Miller, ITN Sport.
And that's it for tonight. The ITV Nightly News is back tomorrow. From all of us here, good night.
evening. A welcome drier respite for the east now. The west, though, will see rain tomorrow. We've got two areas of cloud beginning to join forces and march in from the west, and that will cover many areas by tomorrow, bringing patchy rain here. But further east, a mostly dry scenario. In fact, those areas of cloud beginning to show in the northwest and the southwest tonight, bringing the odd spot of rain. But for the bulk of the country, it will be dry and mostly clear, but one or two fog patches could well form, especially in the central and eastern parts, and the fairly dense patches as well, as it turns very cold indeed. In fact, a widespread frost forming as low as -2 in parts of East Anglia, a little bit warmer out west. Now, tomorrow morning, a dry start for many places, a bright and sunny one in some eastern areas once that fog has cleared. But further west, cloudy from the word go with that patchy rain around. And during the course of the day, I think it will turn rather more persistent and widespread, nudging into some central areas by the end of the afternoon. The heaviest of the rain, though, across western Scotland, staying dry in the east and starting to warm up a touch. Temperatures generally in the range 6 to 9 Celsius, but breezy everywhere. Here's a summary.
Power Gen. Power, whatever the weather.
There now follows a response to the budget by the Shadow Chancellor of the Exchequer, the Right Honourable Francis Maude MP.
You've got to hand it to Labour. They know how to spin the headlines. Their first two budgets hit us with the biggest tax increases in history. But now, they claim to be cutting tax. It's the old, old story. If you're going to tell a lie, make it a big one. There's a very simple fact. Every Labour government in history has put up taxes. And this Labour government, it's no exception. It's already put up taxes by more than £40 billion. That's £1,500 for every taxpayer. Well, they're different in one way. They're much more devious at how they put up taxes. And you know, we've all been tempted by a smooth salesman who promises us the sun, the moon, and the earth. But however persuasive he is, there's a little voice nagging away at the back of our mind that it doesn't quite add up. It's the same with this budget. Gordon Brown's trying to make us believe that tax increases are actually tax cuts, that black is white. He's done it by hitting us all with what we call stealth taxes, hidden taxes that he hopes no one will notice. Even before yesterday's budget, Labour had made it more expensive to get married, to buy a house, to have a mortgage, run a car, or take out a pension for your old age, which is just about everything that most of us want to do. And yesterday the Chancellor hit the same people all over again. Married people, people who own their own homes, people who drive their own cars and run their own businesses, all hit with extra stealth taxes. Well, do you remember what Tony Blair told us before the general election? He promised this: we have no plans to increase taxes at all. At all. Well, that was when he wanted our votes. Last week, he finally had to own up to the truth. The tax burden will increase over this Parliament. 2 years is a long time in politics. Well, of course, there are some things we welcome in the budget. We're glad they're cutting the basic rate of tax from next year. But tax rates aren't everything, are they? Yesterday, the government abolished completely two important allowances, the married couples allowance and tax relief for mortgages. And that means most married people with mortgages will be paying more income tax than they did when Labour came to power. And that's just income tax, before you add in the other stealth taxes on motoring, on savings, on business, on buying your own house, on the self-employed, on insurance. The list is endless. But is all the extra tax that Labour are raising being well spent? People ask, what are we getting for it? Taxes up by £40 billion, yet hospital waiting lists have risen. Taxes up by £40 billion, yet there are fewer police on the beat. Taxes up by £40 billion, yet standards in our schools are stagnating. And a lot of people think, well, Labour are taxing more, all right, but aren't they wasting more as well? That's why we want an annual statement of how much tax we each pay and what that tax is spent on. You might ask, didn't the Conservatives let us down on tax too? Yes, we lost people's trust on tax. I make no bones about that. But we're determined to win that trust back. We want honest taxes, yes, and lower taxes too. Low taxes are good for us all. It isn't just that people do more for themselves and for their families, that that's a good thing. It's more that with lower taxes, we do more for each other and more for our communities. So with lower taxes, society gets stronger. You see, we don't believe that our duty to others ends just by paying our taxes. Even before yesterday's budget, Labour had raised taxes more than any government in history. This budget didn't change that. What they gave with one hand, they took back with the other. It's good headlines, maybe. But the truth is that after this budget, we are paying much more tax under this government. And that's bad for all of us.
That was a response to the budget by the Shadow Chancellor of the Exchequer, the Right Honourable Francis Maud MP.
What a difference a day makes. 24 little hours. What a difference a day makes. And the difference is you.
Let's face it, straight is boring. That's why I love Le Grand Curl. L'Oreal's first mascara ever to curl your lashes all by itself.
Really?
It's new. Amazing technology that actually curls for a longer look.
It's an eye-opener.
So for me, it's bye-bye eyelash curler. And hello, new L'Oreal Le Grand Curl.
Because you're worth it.
Buy a pack of Persil and help raise £250,000 for comic relief. Look out for special packs.
Right Guard Double Protection doesn't just keep you dry, it keeps you feeling fresh from the shower all day.
I can predict the future, but I can plan for the future of my skin.
L'Oreal Plenitude Future E, the moisturizing fluid with pure vitamin E, known to be a powerful skin protector.
It's more than an ordinary moisturizer.
Your skin will feel smoother in just one day.
I can feel it.
Most importantly, pure vitamin E is delivered deeper into your skin so it seems younger in just 1 week.
I can see it.
L'Oreal Plenitude Future E, the daily investment for the future of your skin.
L'Oreal, because I'm worth it, today and tomorrow.
My last cigarette was 7:52 yesterday morning. I put my first nicotine CQ patch on just after. I don't know how I feel yet. I'm still not smoking. 7 days. Nicotine CQ helps take just enough edge off the need. I still want to light up, but I don't have to. I don't have to.
New Nicotine CQ starts you off with our highest level of help, a 24-hour stream that helps calm the cravings. With your willpower, Nicotine CQ can help you stay calm, in control, and quit.
Lloyd's TSB has come together in Norwich. How can we help you live your life?
What can we do to make it happen? To make you feel good, to make you feel good. How can we help you live your life? How can we help you?
Our new personal review service is here in Norwich to help make things happen for you. Lloyd's TSB, your life, your bank.
AirWatch, sponsored by Anglian Home Improvements.
The air quality forecast for the Anglia region. Pollution remains low and is likely to do so for the next couple of days. Ozone gas, which can cause irritation to the lungs, measures highest at Thurrock, but still falls well within the low category today. And nationally, today and tomorrow, pollution is generally low everywhere.
Airwatch, sponsored by Anglian Home Improvements.
Hello, good evening. A new survey has revealed that the eastern counties have the lowest levels of burglary and violent crime in the country. Timothy Evans reports.
PC Chris Halton has been a police officer for more than 25 years. He's responsible for Silver End and some surrounding villages near Witham in Essex. Levels of crime here, and indeed across the region, are among the lowest in the country. It's a reputation which has been confirmed by the latest British Crime Survey. In Suffolk, senior police officers say that's the result of a generally law-abiding community, good policing, and successful partnerships in tackling crime.
Well, I'm delighted to say that the British Crime Survey has always been regarded as an extremely good indicator of levels of crime and disorder in any part of the country. So the fact that the British Crime Survey is showing a downward trend is good news, because that reflects what our own figures have been telling us for a couple of years now.
In three areas, the eastern counties proved to be the safest in the country. 5.6% of households in England and Wales had a burglary or an attempted burglary. In our region, the figure was 3.1%. Nationally, 4.7% of people were the victims of a violent crime. Here, it was 3.9%. For problems like vandalism and graffiti, the national level is set at 100. In East Anglia, the level is 88. All of those figures are the best in the country. The statistics are little comfort for those who are the victims of crime. Nevertheless, incidents like this are relatively rare, and police officers are anxious that people do not have an exaggerated fear of crime.
What do you think police work's all about?
Catching crime.
Catching criminals?
I like to feel that people feel safe in their environment, and I like people to feel that they can come to me if they have a problem and I can try and deal with that issue, whether it's a criminal matter or a personal problem. If it's something that I can help, I'm a member of the community and I feel a responsibility to help.
Police forces across East Anglia have welcomed the picture to emerge from the British Crime Survey, but they say they're not complacent, and even one crime is one too many. Timothy Evans, Anglia News.
Investigators in Essex are trying to find out what started a fire that led to seven people, including two children, having to be rescued. The fire at Walton-on-the-Naze broke out in flats above a row of shops on Newgate Street in the early hours. Firefighters rescued two men using ladders. Two women and two children were led to safety. Another person escaped the fire by climbing down a drain pipe. Two men were taken to hospital suffering from the effects of smoke. Police are investigating why a car went the wrong way along one of Suffolk's busiest roads. A Skoda is reported to have been driven for 5 miles against the flow of traffic on the A14 from the Thousand Guineas service station at Newmarket. It was stopped by police at Quay. A man has been questioned about the incident. If you're a smoker, it's been a thought-provoking couple of days. Yesterday, 17 pence on a packet of cigarettes in the budget. Today, National No Smoking Day. And in the hope of encouraging pregnant women to give up smoking, the government's in the process of setting up a special hotline. But will it have any effect? Malcolm Robertson reports.
For 40 years, John Elvin has worked in the tobacco trade in Norwich. Despite regular increases in the price of cigarettes, he says there's been no noticeable effect on his business. Certainly no reduction in customers today, because it's National No Smoking Day.
None at all. If anything, on the increase, because the regular smokers come out in force today.
Well, these are difficult times for smokers. 19 pence on a packet of cigarettes in December, another 17 and a half pence on a packet yesterday. Just how much will it take for them to say enough is enough? With some brands of popular cigarettes approaching £4 a packet, are we likely to see the habit stubbed out?
At the moment, I'm still smoking because I'm getting them cheaper from people who go abroad, so I probably will give up.
They say B&H now, £1.82 for a pack of 10. If they went up to about £2.15, then I'm going to stop smoking because I can't afford it.
Statistics show smoking kills 120,000 people a year. Smokers are twice as likely to die from heart disease as non-smokers. And if current rates continue, 1 million teenagers will die by the time they reach middle age. Today, Public Health Minister Tessa Jowell was at a women's forum in Norwich and announced the setting up of a special hotline to help pregnant women give up smoking.
About one in four
women smoke when they're pregnant, and almost overwhelmingly those women know that it's bad for them, and even worse, it's very bad for the health of their unborn baby. But giving up smoking, even when pregnant, can be very difficult indeed, because nicotine is so addictive. But all the evidence shows that women who are pregnant double their chances of being able to give up if they have the kind of support that we intend to offer through the Quit Line.
The full implications of the Chancellor's latest increase in tax on tobacco are likely to be felt when new stocks are in the shops. Only then will we know what kind of deterrent it is. Mark and Robertson, Anglia News, Norwich.
Chelmsford got a new water fountain today by accident. Contractors were working for the Essex and Suffolk Water Company on a mains pipe on Navigation Road when it burst, sending gallons of water shooting into the air. Some drivers had a free car wash as they drove past the leak, which happened right outside a plumber's merchant. Finally, tonight, some news just in. Amber flood warnings have just been issued for the rivers Waveney and the Minsmere area. But that's all from us for tonight. We're back at 6:10 tomorrow. Goodbye.
Anglia and Sun Life, helping you plan for tomorrow.
Hello, good evening. There will be some frost tonight, especially inland where it'll get down to -2. A chance of sleet nearer the coast and plenty of fog around. That'll clear during the morning to give a good deal of sunshine tomorrow. Some cloud and rain arriving from the southwest much later in the day. And a look ahead to Friday, mainly dry and very mild. That's it. Good night. Here's the summary.